That's interesting. And so the story goes like the story that El Salvador is going to adopt Bitcoin, it was some time ago as well, right? So it's like,
yeah,
we had that, but now they are also putting extra effort into this, right? And so Amari, you can explain a little bit about that, right? That they are spending a lot of money to figure out what to do with it, right?
Oh, but how can people adopt the Bitcoin? Because I think I didn't understand what
yeah.
you were saying.
What's the figure? I think there was news, the news article that we were discussing, right? Let me see.
Ah, yeah, that the government is investing around, I think, 150 million in order
yes.
to ease this adoption by the public, which I think it is awesome. I find it similar to in my country a few years ago that they enforced that any tax filing needed to be online, and people were complaining about that. As far as I know, people didn't get any help from the government for this, but it is nice to know that El Salvador is actually investing money on that. I'm guessing that they will start some programs on to educate the people on how to use Bitcoin. Although I do know that there are many people who already use Bitcoin to do their transactions, but it will be good to educate the people so the whole country starts using Bitcoin like if it was the normal currency.
Yeah. The project Chivo, right, like you said, it says, so this 150 million is from the 500 million loans El Salvador's finance ministry secured from the American Bank for Economic Integration, right? And so it's a big amount out of this $500 million. And the funds will go, it says, for the creation of at least 200 Bitcoin ATMs and 50 consulting centers in the nation. So they're pretty serious about this, right? It's not just some announcement for hype, basically, right? Nobody knew what was the last time you talked about El Salvador, right? So
yeah.
There is this narrative that maybe they are using this, like, I don't know, for some, oh, look, we are very, you know, up and coming country, and, you know, we are doing all those initiatives and innovation. But all right, 200 Bitcoin ATMs and then 50 consulting centers, that's some serious effort, right?
Yeah.
And they will need to hire people for that, and they will have to grow specialists, basically, Bitcoin specialists and crypto specialists. They have already some, but to staff all the offices, I mean, that takes a lot of work and preparation and education.
Yeah. And this adoption of Bitcoin will also bring some disadvantages, like, for example, money laundering. But
the giveaway scams that all the El Salvadorian will learn soon about. Yeah.
But let's see how it progresses. I am personally excited with that, and I believe this will be the start, the beginning of something wonderful for the crypto sphere.
Yeah. Let's see how the story develops, and we can talk about this.
To watch the full episode, click the first link in the description. If you want others to discover this content, please click like. And if you want more content like this, consider subscribing. Also, chat with us in our Telegram group, which will be the second link in the description. See you there.